Hi friends, welcome you back to the second video on trigonometry. In the previous video, that is the first video, we were discussing about the trigonometric ratios and their relationship between each other, and we did one problem also. I think we will continue, we will do some more problems on that. Given 15 cot A, is equal to 8. Find sine A and secant A. That is the values of these two ratios have to be found out, given 15 cot A is equal to 8. Now, in the first problem that we did in the previous video, he had given two sides of a right angle triangle. He had given two sides of that triangle, and he asked us to write the various trigonometric ratios. Now, in this problem also, he has given two sides, but not directly, indirectly. He has given 15 cot A is equal to 8, or cot A will be equal to, if 15 cot A is equal to 8, then cot A will be equal to 8 divided by 15. So we know a trigonometric ratio of the angle A. Now, if we know one trigonometric ratio of angle A, we know, that means we know two sides. See here, let me draw a triangle, a right angle triangle, a rough figure. It need not be to any dimension, just draw a rough this thing. I'll call this as A, this as B, this as C. So this is angle A. Now he says cot A is equal to 8 by 15. You know, by definition, cot of any angle is the ratio of adjacent side to opposite side. Now, in this triangle, the adjacent side of A is AC and the opposite side is BC. So this is given as 8 by 15. That means this is 8 and this is 15. Now, if we know two sides of a triangle, then I can get the third side. I know in this triangle AB square is equal to BC square plus AC square or CA square. So AB will be equal to square root of BC square plus AC square, that is square root of BC is 15 square plus 8 square, that is 225. 15 square is 225 and 8 square is 64. So if we add those two, you get root of 289. Square root of 289 is 17. So AB is 17. I got the third side. He has given two sides indirectly. So I got those two sides. Then I found out the third side by using the Pythagoras theorem. This is the Pythagoras theorem. Square on the hypotenuse of any right angle triangle is equal to the sum of the squares on the other two sides. That is Pythagoras theorem. Using that, I got that. Now, it is very easy to write the values of, he has asked us to write the value of sine A and secant A, right? Now, sine A, we know by definition, sine is opposite by hypotenuse. Sine A is opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite, as per that sketch, opposite is BC divided by hypotenuse is AB. So BC is 15 by 17. 15 by 17. Next, he wants secant A. Secant is, by definition, secant is hypotenuse by adjacent. It is the reciprocal of cos. Reciprocal of cos. Hypotenuse is AB and adjacent is AC. That is 17 by 8. These are the values of sin A and secant A. Right? Now, such problem can be asked for 2 marks. 2 marks. Similarly, there are other problems. We can do a few more problems for your sake. Given secant theta is equal to 13 by 12. Find all other trigonometric ratios. Find the values of all the other trigonometric ratios of theta, angle theta, trigonometric ratios, right? Again, here he has given one trigonometric ratio of an angle. Same triangle I'll keep. Now this is theta. This angle is called as theta. Now secant theta is 13 by 12. Secant is hypotenuse by adjacent. So I know two sides. Secant theta is hypotenuse by adjacent. That is the reciprocal of cos. Cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. So in this figure which I have drawn, you can take any figure, A, B, C, P, Q, R, L, M, N, whatever you want, you can take. AB is the hypotenuse here and AC is the adjacent side. Now this is given as 13 by 12. So AB is 13, AC is 12. I don't know BC. Now if I know any two sides of a right angle triangle, applying the Pythagoras theorem, I can get the third side. Third side can be got. You know, AC square plus BC square is equal to AB square. That is, sum of the squares on the other two sides is equal to the square on the hypotenuse. Here AB is the hypotenuse. Now what I want is BC. Now BC square I'll keep here will be equal to AB square minus AC square. I'll send this AC square that side, it becomes minus AC square. So AB square is 13 square. AB square, AB is 13. So AB square will be 13 square minus AC square. AC is 12. So 12 square. Now, once this 13 square is 169, that is 13 into 13 minus this is 12 square is 144. 12 into 12 is 144. So that will give you 25. So BC will be, BC square is 25. So BC will be root of square root of 25. That is 5. So I got this as 5. If these two are 12 and 13, then that will be 5. 5 units. Whatever unit, 5 units. Now, I know all the three sides, all the three sides of the right angle triangle, so I can write all the trigonometric ratios, that is sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec theta. You need not write secant theta because already that is given by himself, so cot theta. So all these five, other than secant theta, we can write. This is opposite by hypotenuse, that is 5 by 13. This is adjacent by hypotenuse. So it will be adjacent is 12 by 13. Tan is opposite by adjacent, that will be 5 by 12. Cosec is the reciprocal of sine, that is hypotenuse by opposite, that is 13 by 5. Cot is the reciprocal of tan, that is adjacent by opposite. Tan is opposite by adjacent, so cot will be adjacent by opposite, that is 12 by 5. So these are the ratios: 5 by 13, 12 by 13, 5 by 12, 13 by 5, and 12 by 5. These are the other trigonometric ratios of angle theta. So this finishes that problem. Now, like this, you have number of problems here. You have a number of problems. Same thing. You can do it. Now, let us see one more problem I'll take. Very quickly, I'll take one more problem. If cot theta is 7 by 8, evaluate, that means find the value of. Evaluate means nothing but find the value of. Number one, 1 plus sine theta into 1 minus sine theta divided by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. And second problem, find the value of, that is evaluate cot square theta. Now, here we can do it as we did previously. That is, if we know cot theta, we know two sides of a right angle triangle. Using that, we can find out the third side. Then we can find out the values of this. We can do it little differently also. See, like this, we can do it by a short method. By looking at this problem, the first problem, you see here, you must be a little intelligent. Now, 1 plus sine theta into 1 minus sine theta. 1 plus sine theta into 1 minus sine theta. Now, this is of the form A plus B into A minus B. Similarly, 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. This is also A plus B into A minus B. Now the product of these two will be A square minus B square. You know this algebraic relationship. A plus B into A minus B. The product of A plus B and A minus B is A square minus B square. So apply that here. You will get this as 1 minus sine square theta. 1 minus sine square theta. If you apply that same relationship here, you will get 1 minus cos square theta. We know 1 minus sine square theta is cos square theta divided by 1 minus cos square theta is sine square theta, because sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. We have proved that. So 1 minus sine square theta will be cos square theta. 1 minus cos square theta will be sine square theta. Then cos theta by sine theta is cot theta. So it is cot square theta. Cos square theta by sine square theta is cot square theta. Now he has given the value of cot theta. So this is 7 by 8 the whole square. Cot square theta, that is 49 by 64. This is the answer. The second problem is very simple. He has asked cot square theta given cot theta. So again it is 7 by 8 the whole square. That answer is also 49 by 64. That is the answer. Same answer for both. 1 and 2, the answer is same. You can do some more problems here see that it is you get them correctly. By doing a number of problems, what happens is you get to by heart. These will come by themselves, they will come by heart. If you are using them again and again and again, if you use them, they will become by heart. You need not strain yourselves to by heart them. I hope you have understood this. If you have understood it, if you think that it is beneficial, you tell others, you tell your friends to watch it, let them also get benefited. They don't have to pay anything, they can get the benefit like you. Next, we can take up the trigonometric ratios of well-known angles. The next step is trigonometric ratios of well-known angles.